With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hi everyone, so we are given with a question which says the galvanometer deflection when the key K1 is closed but K2 is open equals to theta naught, as we can see in the figure. On closing K2 and adjusting the value of R2 to 5 ohm, the deflection of the galvanometer becomes theta naught by 5. The resistance of the galvanometer is then given by, we can neglect the internal resistance of the battery. So here we have to find the value of resistance of galvanometer G. So we can divide whole of the question into two parts. So first is when K1 is closed. Let's write it clearly. And K2 is open. So when K1 is closed and K2 is open, the current will flow only through the galvanometer. And let's suppose that current to be as I1. So I1 can be written as V, that is by Ohm's law we can write it as E upon total resistance, that is 220 plus of G. Alright, so let's suppose that this is our equation 1, and also we have been given that this current is the galvanometer deflection is theta naught. So we can write here as theta naught. Why I am writing directly theta naught as I1? Because we know for galvanometer the current is directly proportional to the angle of deflection. Alright, so now let's move on to the second part. In the second part it says switch K2 is closed. Now both the keys are closed, so we can write K1, K2 both are closed, and if both are closed we can say the current that is flowing through the circuit can be given as total. I am writing it as I only, that is total current in the circuit can be again calculated by using Ohm's law, that is E upon total resistance. Total resistance, we can see R1 is in series with R2 and RG, means G. As R2 and G both are in parallel and they are in series with R1, so we can write the equivalent resistance, that can be written as 220 plus of the parallel combination of R2 and G, that can be written as R2 into G divided by R2 plus of G. All right, and we have been given the value of R2 as to be 5 ohm, we will substitute the value of R2 as 5, so we can write it as E over 220 plus of 5G, and that's divided by 5 plus G. On cross multiplying the term, we will get that value of total current in the circuit as E into G plus 5, and that's divided by we can write it as 1100 plus of 220 G plus 5G, that comes out to be 225 G. I'm directly writing 225 G. All right, now we have been now in the second part we have been told that the deflection of galvanometer is theta naught by 5. So galvanometer shows deflection when the current passes through it. So if the current, we have supposed that the I current is flowing through the circuit and this I gets distributed, let's suppose that into I1, and let's suppose it has to be to avoid the confusion, we have already used the I1 over here, so we will write it as the current will get distributed into let's say I1 and let's say I2. All right, so for I2 value of current, when I2 current is passing through G, so galvanometer will show theta naught by 5 deflection. So we need to first calculate the value of I2. So for that we will write, also it's been given I2 is equals to theta naught by 5. Alright, so this is this deflection comes into picture when the current passes through the galvanometer. As same is the first case, when I1 current was passing through the galvanometer, because no current were passing through this resistance or in this elements, so we have written theta as theta naught as I1. All right, so Now we are interested in finding the value of I2. For I2, I would suggest to remember this trick. So we are interested in finding the current through this resistance, that is through galvanometer. So for that, we will write first the total current value. That is, we have calculated it as E into G plus 5, total value of current. And after that, we will write the resistance, which is we are interested in finding current through this galvanometer. So resistance left will be R2. So we will write here as R2 and divided by total resistance, that is R2 plus G. So this is the way we will calculate the current through the resistance. Let's say if we have to calculate current through R2, so we would have kept G upon R2 plus G into total current. All right, so this is the way we will calculate the value of current I2. So from here, if you substitute the value of R2 as 5, so this term and this term will get cancelled out, and we are left with 5e and divided by 5e divided by 111 1100 plus of 225 g, and that is equals to theta naught by 5. So here theta we have calculated in the equation 1. So theta naught can be directly replaced as E by 220 plus G. So E by 220 plus G into 5 is already over here. So from here we will solve this equation and we will get the value of G. E gets cancelled out and we are left with 1100 plus of 225 G, and that is equals to this comes out to be 5500 plus of 5G into 5, that is 25 G. Alright, so here the value comes out to be 200 G, and that is equals to 4400. Therefore the value of G can be written as 22 ohms. So the resistance of galvanometer is 22 ohms. So I hope you have understood the concept, and thank you for watching.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.